Hello, this is Charlie Zorro, and welcome to episode 12 in the Adventures of Denesha. Denesha is in Noglin, which is one of the dwarven outposts in Ered Luin. And we're going to take some time today to just kind of explore the area and show you a couple of things. One of the things that I want to show you is actually here in Noglin. So let's run up. There's a path right up here. And one of the things that you can do is you can actually get on the buildings here in Noglin. So that's kind of neat. And then we can hop off, come down here. Whoops. You can patrol the area. Unfortunately, the doors is fake, so you can't really get out or get through. But it's kind of neat. Kind of look around. And we can just come over here and hop off. And there we go. So that's one of the things you can kind of do. So Noglin's kind of a fun place. Now, let's go ahead and mount up, and I'll show you a couple other things. As you're traveling south from Thorn's Hall to Gondamon, or north from Gondamon to Thorn's Hall, you're going to go over, or you're going to go through this overpass. And you can actually get on the overpass from the south side. By going up the hill. Now, I've yet to figure out a way of getting up there. Unfortunately, the cliff in front of us is kind of blocked off to where you can't get to it. But at least you can get to this point, which is still pretty cool as far as I'm concerned. And the nice thing is, you can get off the bridge without having to plummet to your death. So let's go ahead and mount up again. Now, in our last episode, we were in Rath-Therang, and we saw the southern barricade. And looking through the barricade, you could tell where the road continued on, but you couldn't go any further. Basically, it was blocked. And technically, the game kind of ends there, and hopefully someday they'll open up the area. But until they do, oh, goblin, you little jerk. Come back here. Anyway, until they do, all we can do is basically just go there and look out through it and wish. Well, up this path, there is a similar block. Oh, and we're not high enough level to just walk through it, so. Oh yeah, we are, okay. Except for the goblin. Hope the lynx won't attack. Anyway, here's another one of the gates. So again, kind of looks like you should be able to just squeeze through, but you can't. And unfortunately, you can't really get too good a view of it, but it definitely looks like the road continues on and then around the mountain. And if you look at your radar, it definitely shows that that's kind of what's going on. So anyway, this is another one of those areas where if they ever go ahead and expand the game into the southern regions, hopefully they'll get rid of this gate and you can actually continue on. So that'll be kind of cool. Okay, let's pull back a little bit. All right. Also, from up here, it's a really nice view of the surrounding area. And you don't have to worry about the lynx. They won't chase you usually. Okay, the next place that I want to take you, and we'll see if Denesha's high enough level to just walk through or whether we get to fight. It's one of the main goblin strongholds in northern Ered Luin. And it's just outside Noglin and down this road. You can see it up above us. And no, she is not high enough level to avoid the goblins. So we're going to have to fight our way through, which is just fine. There are quests. Oh, actually, she is high enough level. Okay, let's see what happens. Ordost is the name of the place. And there are quests if you take the... if you're a dwarf and you take the dwarven quests that will actually take you here. Oh. And you get to basically fight these guys a little bit more on level. And again, this is a very good place to come if you're looking at trying to complete your Goblin Slayer quests or deeds. And I always love coming to this point because that's Noglin right in front of Denesha. And then there's the bridge that we were just on. And up there is the path that's blocked. So you can kind of see the pretty much the surrounding area from up here, which is really kind of cool. So let's continue on. That's kind of cool. Alright. It's really kind of fun because if you're a higher level and you're a hunter, you can just walk through this place and just one-shoot these guys left and right and complete your Slayer deed in like no time at all. Okay. Back here, let's see if we can get through here. Have no idea what's up with that goblin. But if we continue up this path, We're going into a high level area. In fact, if you select one of those dwarves, you see that he's 48th level. And there is no way that someone at 15th level is going to be able to take them out. So you are now in Sarnur, which is, again, a high-level area. But what's really cool is there is a public dungeon, or a public instance, that you can come into, and basically it is a dwarven cave. And Denesha can't go much further in this because they will one-shoot her. But it's very cool. For example, and it's time to run like hell. Okay. So it's time to run. But basically, when you get to be 46 level or somewhere around there, you'll get a quest, or actually you'll be eligible for a quest to let you come up here. And what you'll do is you'll go to Thorn's Hall to pick it up, and it's really cool. It is extremely fun with a fellowship. So I thought you might be interested in that. Now we'll see if we can't hightail it out of here. Now, you'd think this is the way to go, but it's not. So, I can't tell you how many times I fell for that. Literally fell for that. And now we're going to take these two guys out again, but that's okay. Oh, for crying out loud. Come back up here. Okay, I'm just going to get on our horse and book. Okay. For you foresters and hunters, or hunters, for you foresters and tailors, there's another great place to get light hides. And that's between Noglin and Thorn's Hall. I forget the exact name of it. We'll find out in just a few minutes because we're going to go ahead and go into it. Basically, it's to our right. It's all up along the mountain range. And so this is one of the ways of getting into it. There we go. We want to go up. I want to go far enough where it actually tells us the name of it. Can't pull up. And there's one of the links that do follow us. Okay, well, we'll take you out. Oh, I guess we won't. We're running away. Also, I love the scenery here. This is just gorgeous. Well, I thought that it would tell us what the name of it is, but check my map. The Hunter's Notch. That's where you want to go to, and it's on the map. And that's where you can go ahead and get lots of light hides. Where we're going to go now is there are some ruins up here that you can get to. That's kind of cool. Well, maybe I shouldn't say ruins, but unfortunately you can't get in here, but it does offer a very nice vantage point because there's the goblin stronghold we were just at, And I think if you come over here, you can see a little bit more. Yeah. Maybe not. But it's kind of neat. That, unfortunately, is about it as far as what you can do. So I tell you what, I'm going to pause the video real quick, and we'll pick up as we get closer to Thorn's Hall. Okay, we're back. We're not actually closer to Thorn's Hall. I just saw another area that Denisha's kind of interested in since she's a swimmer. Right behind us is Noglin. And so if you come across the road, you will see this. And I'm kind of curious to see just how far it goes. And that's as far as it'll go. Okay. Again, a little disappointing. But as we get closer, let's take a look. Again, an area that perhaps someday they'll open. Unfortunately, there's not much you can see here. I apologize for that. I was kind of hoping there'd be more. But it does look cool. Let's see what's on this side. Now you can see Noglin a little bit easier or clearer. Oh, wow. There we go. Thought she should be able to get up on the rocks. Yeah. And while I've never tried it, you might be able to slide off that cliff and get on top of it. I may try that someday. But not today. So, I'll pause the video and we'll catch up in just a moment. Okay, welcome back. We are approaching Thorin's Hall, or actually Thorin's Gate. This isn't it, this is just another building, which is kind of cool. You can kind of see it better from back here. And again, unfortunately, we can't get on top, at least not that I'm aware of. But then I need to spend some time doing a little bit more exploring to find out. So we've arrived at Thorin's Gate. And there's another building here, which is kind of interesting. If you're a jeweler, this dwarf will give you a quest. So it's a crafting quest, but it's kind of cool. So anyway, you can come up here. And to my knowledge, that building doesn't have a name. Guess it should be called the Jeweler's Building, but who knows. And that, well, beyond the statue, is Thorin's Hall, which we will go into in a little bit. All right, from here, this is a crafting area. And if you remember from the intro, this is the Silverdeep Guardhouse, which you cannot go into, which really, really sucks. So, let's continue on. This is the way to the Thorin's Gate homesteads. And the homesteads are in front of us. So if you're interested in having a dwarven house and you're 15th level or above, this is the place to come. But that's not where we're going to go. We're going to go up this path. and take a look at a couple things. Let's go over here. Try not to fall off. And that's a view of Thorn's Gate. Oh my goodness, I have never noticed that the structure directly in front of Denesha appears to be a dwarf. A giant dwarf. That is very cool. I've never noticed that before. Alright, now let's head up the path. And when you go as high as you can, you're basically above the river. And that is a long, long way down. And as you can see, there is a gate. So you can swim up to the river, or up to the gate, and look through it. But there's really not much. I mean, you can't go any further than that. And I have tried. You can't, at least not that I've found, you can't jump on that, the top of the gate bridge. So, because you just can't get to that up there. Come on. Because it just won't let you go any higher. Which really kind of sucks. But I can understand why they don't want you up there. So anyway. That's one of the areas. It's kind of off the beaten path. And now we're going to head back to Askelion, and I'll show you the path that I was talking about there. So I will be right back. Okay, Denesha has arrived at the ruins of Askelion. And we have a lone elf keeping vigil. So this is where we go for the dwarven and elven intros. And one thing to be aware of is if you go down this path, this takes you into the back entrance of the rocky pit, or the rock belly pit. And you can certainly go through and explore again. I expect there's probably bats or somebody or something in there. I haven't really played around in there. But that's kind of neat. I found that by accident. So let's continue on. It's so much better being able to ride a horse through here. It's so much faster. And the Silver Deep Mine is right below us. And it too is active, so you can go ahead and go into that as well. And now we're in the Refuge of Askelion. And you can explore this area. I mean, it's kind of neat. Just kind of going around, seeing what's available, what's here. But where I want to go is through the locked gate, which now is open. Because if you remember from the intro, this gate was closed. And when I first came through here, I was thinking, oh boy, a new area. Well, sort of. there is another area here. And from here it looks like it's open until you get a little bit closer and the system actually draws in the gate. So this is another area that Turbine could expand upon and open up for play. If nothing else, it would be interesting if they just did an instance or something where you could come up here and, I don't know, just explore a, you know, an immediate area or something. Just something new for the lower level characters to play around with. Now, the last time I was up here, there were goblins here, but apparently not now. And again, you can't go into this either. But this is kind of neat. This is just kind of tucked away. It's not on the map. As a matter of fact, if you go to the map, you can see where we're off of it. And so I think it's pretty cool. It's just kind of a little area. I mean, you could get a band together and come up here and play, and probably no one would bother you. So again, kind of a role-playing area, or just kind of an off-the-beaten-track place to explore. So let's head back to Thorin's Gate. Actually, we're going to swing by the Silver Deep Mine and complete the Places of the Dwarves deed. But I love this area. This is gorgeous. They've done such a great job. And again, you can just come up and all sorts of places to explore and take a look at. And this is one of the ways into the Silver Deep Mine. We're not actually going to go into the mine. I don't think we have to complete the deed. Nope. That's all we have to do is just be here. But the mine is over there and it's active, so you can certainly go in and explore and do whatever you'd like. And I should say all the mines from the intro are available. Okay, let's go ahead and head up to Thorin's Gate. And if you have a chance, and you probably will sometime during your gameplay, is you want to come up to Thorin's Gate and just kind of explore inside. This is the main city or stronghold of Ered Luin. It offers not only a vault master, actually a couple vault masters, there we go, but an auction house, a crafting area, you know, basically everything except for a stable master. So at this point, we have completed all of the deeds of Ered Luin. One last thing I guess I should show you is over here, even though at this level it won't help you or be of any use to you, but this is a skirmish camp. So once you've reached 20th level and you have a skirmish soldier, you can come up here to enhance its abilities or buy different items or things of that nature. So once you have some marks. So anyway, that's it for Ered Luin. In our next adventure, we'll go ahead and begin Denesha's actual adventures outside of her birth area. We'll go ahead and enter the Shire and kind of start looking at doing some of the Shire quests, do their Shire deeds, and eventually move on to Bree. So I certainly hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed seeing different places that you can explore in Northern Ered Luin. If you did enjoy the video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And until next time, safe journeys and take care.